This is what the HTML code of bugzilla.mozilla.org looks like. It actually is almost 900 lines of HTML. So you feed this into the Mozilla browser, select print, and it crashes. But why? In the early days of Mozilla, problem reports such as this one and failures such as this one came in quicker than Mozilla programmers could possibly simplify them or even look at them. But then the Mozilla product managers had a clever idea. They started the Mozilla Bugathon, which meant that volunteers would go and simplify test cases. This was a very simple process. What you needed is a text editor, such as this one. And then you would go and remove parts of the HTML page, say this for instance, run this through Mozilla and see whether the failure still persists. And again, remove some part of the input and see whether the failure still persists. Again and again and again. And you repeat this until you have a page left, a small page, in which everything is relevant for reproducing the failure. If you do this and keep on removing one part after the other, and then all of a sudden you end up in a situation where the failure no longer occurs. After you removed some part, the failure no longer occurs. What do you do next? Do you put the part you just removed back in and try to remove other parts? Or do you keep only the part that you just removed and remove everything else? Or do you keep on removing until the failure occurs again? Over to you.